You've created your first lead magnet, and now it's time to create a landing page. So watch me create a Systeme.io landing page in just minutes. Let's get started. The first thing that you'll need to do is to get your Systeme.io account all set up. I've put a link in the description box below this video that will allow you to get your account set up free of charge. So once you click on that link, you're going to be directed to this page. And all that you'll need to do is to enter in your email address and then click on free account. Now, one thing I do want to suggest to you is that you use a professional or business email address. If you don't currently have one, don't worry, you can get one all set up in just a few minutes. I've created a video and the link is just above, which will walk you through the entire process where you can get it set up in 15 minutes or less. So once you click on Get My Free Account, you're going to land on the dashboard. Now here on the dashboard, what we're going to do is to begin creating your landing page. In Systeme.io, that landing page is going to be created under the Funnels tab. So the way that you're going to do that is come up to the top where it says Funnels, you're going to click on that, and then what you're going to do is go over to the right side where it says Create. Once you click on that, we can now start to enter the information that Systeme.io is going to need. So I'm going to go ahead and put in the name of my funnel, and now I have to tell Systeme.io what my goal is. Well, in our case, it's to build an audience. We want to collect email addresses and to build an email list. So once you click on that, now you can go ahead and click Save. Once you click Save, the next thing we're going to do is actually click on the name of the funnel that we just created. And now what we can do is to begin setting up the actual landing page and the thank you page. Those are the only two steps that we're going to need in our funnel. So up at the top, you're going to see squeeze page. That's just another term for landing page. And what I love about Systeme.io is in order to create a page, they have a ton of beautifully designed templates that are fully customizable. All that you need to do is to find one that contains the information you need and then customize it to your liking. So what I'm going to do is to go over to the right side here and then just begin scrolling down. I'm going to go over and to the bottom and change this from displaying 9 to displaying 30 per page. And then what I'll do is to find a template that I like so I can begin the process of customizing it. All right, so here's a template that I think I want to use. If you want to actually see what it looks like, you can click on Preview Template, and that's going to give you an example of what that template will look like before it's customized. Now, what I'm going to do is go back, click on Select, and now what I want to start doing is customizing the information. So I'm going to go ahead and put in Create Your First Ebook. And then what I have to do is to give it a URL path that's going to be unique, meaning it hasn't been used within my account. And then once you click somewhere, it's going to check that. And if it's available, you'll get that green check mark. Now what I can begin to do is to customize the actual template. So I'm going to come over and hover over where it says Edit Page and then click on that. Now what I want to do is to show you how Systeme.io templates are set up. So the first thing you'll notice is that there are sections, and then within sections there are rows, and within rows there are elements. All of the elements are going to be located over on the left-hand side. You can use any of these in your template, but because of the way this one is set up, I really don't have to do a lot of customization. So let me show you how I'll begin to customize it. All right, so I'm going to change all of this out. Now, I don't want this green color, so in order to change that out, I'm going to highlight it, go up to this green square, click on that, and then what I can do is to either put in my hex code, if you happen to know that, hit enter, and then that will automatically change it. I also want to do the same thing here. And if I click on that green square, you'll notice that it has changed or saved my brand color. Now, the other thing I want to do is to change this out, and I want to go back to the color that appears here, and I want to take the bold off. So now that field has been in fact customized. Now the next thing I want to do is come down and I want to change this out to a picture of my lead magnet. So I hover over it and then you'll see this gear icon. Once I click on that, it's going to allow me to work with this field. Now you'll notice that this is an image file. So in order to change this out and put my own in, I'm just going to hover over this little cloud with an up arrow. And what that's going to allow me to do is either drag and drop in my file, or if I already have done so, all I have to do is to click on your images, find my file, and click insert. Now you'll notice it came in a bit larger than the other side where this box is, and I'd like for that to all match up. So all I have to do is to make sure this is highlighted, and you can tell that it is with that blue box around it. So all I have to do is to grab this image size slider and just slide it to the left until it gets to the size that I want. That looks pretty good. So now that's all set. The next thing I want to do is to come over and customize this field. So the same thing is going to be true. I'm going to just highlight this and I want that to be changed to my brand color. And then what I want to do is change this out and say your free guide. All right. That works fine. Now what I want to do is to come down to the button that people will click after they enter their first name and their email address. So where this says get report, this is the button I'm going to be changing. So you'll do the same thing. You'll use the gear icon, you'll click on that, and then over on the left-hand side, all I have to do is come down to the section that says color, and then I'm going to click on that, change that to my brand color. There's one other change that I want to make and I want to show you. If you'll notice, this has a green highlight around it. Once again, I don't want that. So in order to do so, I just scroll further down the page, find the color, change that to my brand color, and that's all set. Now there's a couple of other things that I want to change here. So I'm going to go up to the top. And this is very important that you do this. So the first thing I want to do is I want to make sure it says submit form when it says action when button is clicked. And then the next thing I want to do is to make sure where it says do you want to redirect users after contact registration? And I do. I want to go to the next step. So I'm going to click on that. What this is going to do is when people enter in the information and click the button, it's going to move them to the next step of the process, but it's also going to submit the form so that the email process can begin. And I'm going to show you that a little bit later. Now, this is pretty well done. Now, of course, I could go in and make other changes, but for the sake of time, I'm just going to leave it as is. The most important thing is after you make any changes, come up to the top where it says Save Changes, click that and make sure it does in fact save. Once you do that, now you can safely exit this page. So I'm going to click on the arrow and exit. The next thing I have to do is to customize my thank you page. So we're going to do the same type of steps. We're going to click on thank you page, find one that we like, and once you find one, all you're going to do then is begin the process of customizing it. So let's go ahead and select this one. It doesn't really matter which one we select. And now what I want to do is to change this so that I can in fact work with it. So I've already given it the name, thank you, create your first ebook. And I'm just going to leave the URL path as it is. So we're going to begin the process of customizing it by clicking on edit page. Once I click on edit page, remember how everything is set up with sections and then rows and then also elements. So I don't want any of this because I want to make this really simple. So let's go ahead, hover over it, click the trash can and confirm that we want to delete it. Same thing is going to be true here. I want to get rid of all of this. I don't need any of that. The next thing I want to do is to show you how to change out this image. So I'll do the same thing. I'll click on the gear icon, come over to the left-hand side, and find where the image file is on here. So once you locate the image file, which is right here, click on the up arrow in the cloud, click on your images, and find an image, and then insert it. All right, now you'll notice it came in with her head kind of cut off. So to fix that, all I have to do is to come down, click on this section that says display image, and then I'm going to change it so it says full center fixed. All right, next thing, we're just gonna get rid of some of this because I don't need any of that. And then the final thing that I'm going to do is to show you how you can customize this section as well. So as you know, the gear icon is going to allow you to make changes. But what I also want to show you is down here, this is a great way for you to actually lead people to other ways they can connect with you. So if, for example, I wanted to send people to my YouTube page, I can hover over that, click on the gear icon, copy that, come back over, and then what I'm going to do is to paste in the link and click somewhere, and I also want that to open up in a new window. Now, if you don't have any of these other social media accounts that you want to send people to, just remember all you have to do is hover over them and click the trash can and you can get rid of it. Now, the other thing you can do is if you want to change this section out, you can do the same thing, hover over, come over, and put in your brand colors. Now, the last thing I want to share with you, if I wanted to change all of this out, I would just go through the process of changing the information as we demonstrated on the previous page. Now, the last thing I want to show you about these, and this will ring true for both the landing page and the thank you page, is if you come over to the left-hand side, you're going to see two icons, a desktop icon and also a mobile icon. So if I were to click on the mobile icon, it's going to allow me to see how it would appear on a phone, and I could make changes as well if I wanted to do that here. Now, if I go back to the desktop icon, then I can see how everything appears. Now, once I have all of this all set up, the only thing you need to do again is to remember to save your changes, and once it has successfully saved, now you can exit. Now that we have exited, the next thing we want to do is to set up the email message. If you'll notice the way I have the funnel set up, it directs people to a thank you page, but the thank you page is telling them to check their email account in order to get the lead magnet. So we're going to now set that up. The way that we would do that is you're going to come up to the top where it says emails. We're going to go down to campaigns, and now what we're going to do is to create our campaign. What we're going to be doing in this example is just creating a single email message, but know that you can have multiple email messages that could go out using this feature. So I'll click on create, and now what I'm going to do is to put in a name for my campaign. So I'm going to say, create your first ebook. And then what I have to do is select an email address that I want to use. And this is where it's important for you to use a professional or business email address. If you're attempting to use a free email address like Gmail or Yahoo or any of the others, chances are really good that your email is going to end up in someone's spam folder. So take the time to set up that professional email address. All right, so once we have that all set up, now I'm going to click on save, and then I'm going to customize the email. So all I have to do is to click on this, and then what I'm going to do is create my first email. So I'm going to click on create, and then what I have to do is to put in the information. What I have done is I have an email message that I have written, so I'm just going to be doing a copy and paste right over into these fields. So I'm going to put in the subject line. This is the subject line that people are going to see when they receive it in their inbox. And then what I'm going to do is leave this set to classic editor, because if I were to change it to visual editor, it's going to give me templates. And unfortunately, when you use templates, those tend to end up being marked as spam. So I just want to use a classic editor, which is going to allow me to just simply put in text. So now I'm going to click on save. And now what I can do is to copy in the email that I have in fact created. So I'm just going to copy that and paste it in. And now what I want to do is to customize my email, because if you remember, I did request people to enter their first name. So in order to do that, what I do is come over to this section that says substitute variables, click on that, and then click on first name. Now what's going to happen is if people entered their first name, when they receive this email, this first name info will be substituted with their actual name. The next thing I have to do is to put in a link to the actual lead magnet. So where it says here, what I'm going to do is to go over to where I have this stored and grab the link. Now you can store it in Google Drive, or you can store it in Dropbox, or wherever your favorite storage place would be. So I'm going to go ahead and grab the link from Dropbox, head back over, and then to put it in, you'll click on this link icon and then just simply paste it in, click the check mark, and now it is there. All right, and then you can do any other customization that you would need to. Now, what I recommend you do is once you get to this point, save, click on save and test. And what we want to do is to send out a test email just to make sure that everything is set up the way we want. And once you know it's set up the way that you want, then what you can do is go ahead and click on save and publish. Now, one thing that's going to happen is once you click on save and publish, it's going to ask you what type of delay do you want to put in. I really want it to go out fairly quickly, so I'm just going to say 1 and change this from days to minutes and click activate. All right, so once I do that, make sure you click save again. I always do, it really is already saved. Now what I can do, if I scroll down, you'll see that the activate settings are in fact here. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and click exit. Now, we're still not yet done. We have to now connect our funnel with our email message. So the way we're going to do that is go back to funnels, click on the funnel that you just created, go to automation rule. And what I want to now do is click on automation rules and add in a rule. So now what I have to do is to add a trigger. So the trigger is going to be this funnel step form subscribe. So when people actually subscribe, this is going to trigger this to happen. So I'm going to click on that. And now what I want to do is to go ahead and edit the automation rule. So once I do that, I'm going to click on add action, subscribe to a campaign, and what I then have to do is to click on the campaign that I have already set up. Once you do that, the next thing to remember is to save the rule, all right? And so now that you've done that, everything's all set up. So let's go back and just show you what it's going to look like. So if I were to click on funnel, here is my actual funnel. So if I were to put in my first name and an email address that I have access to and then click on get report, what it's going to do is submit and then move me to the thank you page. All right, so just to show you that this does in fact work, if I go back to the funnel and if I go to contacts and click on that, you'll see that it has in fact added in an actual new contact because I submitted the form. All right, so now if I were to go to that inbox after about a minute's time, and here is the email that came out from the campaign. If I were to click on that, you'll see that the email is in fact there. And if I were to click on download or where it says here, you'll see what it's going to do is to pull in that lead magnet that has been created. So as you can see, it does in fact work. Now, the great thing about setting up your landing page and collecting email addresses is it's going to give you the opportunity to really build a relationship with your email subscribers. Now, there's one more thing that I think is extremely important, and that is to take things a step further by not just having a single email message that goes out, but really creating an entire campaign. Now, the great thing about setting up an actual email campaign is you're not limited to just one email message going out. As a matter of fact, I would encourage you to send out a series of email messages to new subscribers once they come into your funnel. So in order to do that, I want to walk you through a process that's going to show you exactly how to do that. And so what I want you to do is to check out this video next, where I show you how to go from that single email message that we did with Systeme.io to a series of messages. And what that's going to do is to help you build that know, like, and trust factor. So thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.